स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न लेसन नंबर 7, दैट इज रॉक्स एंड रॉक टाइप्स. ओके, सो हियर इन योर सराउंडिंग यू मस्ट हैव सीन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ रॉक्स. यस ऑर नो? यू मस्ट हैव सीन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ स्टोन्स, रॉक्स. ओके, सो टुडे बेसिकली वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ रॉक्स, ओके, एंड देयर टाइप्स. सो हियर, व्हाट इज रॉक? What is rock, children? Here, it is the solid mineral material forming part of the surface of the earth and other similar planets exposed on the surface or underlying the soil. You must have seen that, okay? You must have seen that on the surface of the earth, yes or no? Clear? Which is exposed on the surface of, which is actually this, this rock is exposed on the surface or it is underlying the soil. Okay, now here, children, we know very well about the earth's crust. Okay, how is our earth's crust? It is hard. Okay, now what is crust? First of all, we have learned about but it, okay, but still we are going to revise. Okay, what is crust? It is the tough outer part of the earth. Okay, what is crust? It is the tough outer part, okay, of the earth. So how is our earth's crust? It is hard. Okay, it is what? It is hard. It is made up of rocks and soils. Now these rocks, they are found where? They are found on the land surface and also below it. Yes or no, children? We have found that rocks are below, they are on the land surface as well as they are below it. Okay, they are the mixture of different minerals. Okay, now what are these rocks? They are the mixture of different minerals and which are formed by natural processes in the lithosphere. Okay, they are what? The natural processes which are happening in the lithosphere, they are made from that. Okay, so here lithosphere, we have studied about the spheres of earth, that hydrosphere, atmosphere, lithosphere. So the rocks are what? They are formed by natural processes which are happening in the lithospheres. Okay, and they are the mixture of different minerals. So now the properties, now here the properties of rocks, what they it depends on the constituent minerals. Okay, so now the properties of rocks, their characteristics, their properties, it will be completely different minerals. Okay, and their proportion also. Okay, how much percentage of the constituent minerals are present in it. Okay, as well as on how it is formed. Okay, how it is formed, on the formation process. Now, silica, aluminium, magnesium, and iron are the major rock forming minerals. They are what? These iron, magnesium, aluminium, silica, it is what? They are the major rock forming minerals. There are other minerals also, children, okay, which are present in different rocks. Okay, now we are going to study about the types of rocks. We studied about the formation. Okay, we studied about the formation of rocks, how it is formed. It is formed because of natural processes. Now, first we will study about the types of rocks now. Okay, three types we are going to study based on the formation process. Okay, first one is igneous rocks or primary rocks. Second is sedimentary rocks, and third one is metamorphic rocks. Okay, so one by one we will study. Now igneous rocks, you can see, children, in the picture about the igneous rocks. Okay, these are what? They are the igneous rocks in the picture. Okay, in the PPT you can see. Now igneous rocks are what? Okay, now children, you know about, we have studied about the volcanic eruptions and all. Yes or no? We studied about the volcanic eruptions, okay, and in that we studied about the lava and magma. Okay, we studied about it. Okay, so now when the molten material, now what is molten material? It is known as magma. Okay, now what is magma? It is the hot fluid. और सेमी फ्लूइड लिक्विड मटेरियल बिलो और विद इन द अर्थ क्रस्ट. ओके दिस इज द मैग्मा. इट इज वेरी हॉट एंड फ्लूइड और सेमी फ्लूइड मटेरियल. एंड वेर इट इज बिलो और विद इन द अर्थ क्रस्ट. ओके सो this magma which is within the earth's crust and the lava which is present on the surface. Okay, magma is where? Within the earth's crust, and lava which is on the earth's surface. Okay, what happens when it cools down? When this hot fluid, okay, this hot molten material, when it cools down, it solidifies. Okay, it becomes solid. Okay, when it cools down, when this hot fluid material, liquid kind of material, when it cools down, okay, it solidifies, giving rise to rocks. Okay, when it becomes solid, it gives rise to the formation of rocks. Okay, because of it, rocks are formed. So such rocks are called as what? Igneous rocks. What are they called as? Igneous rocks. Okay, now here we will learn about their characteristics now, igneous rocks characteristics. Now children, see, as these rocks, we know very well how are they formed. They are formed out of the material which is present in the interior of the earth, right? So as these rocks are formed out of the material which is present in the interior of the earth, that is why they are called as primary rocks. Okay, see, we have seen in that previous PPT that igneous rocks are also called as primary rocks. So why they are called as primary rocks? Because they are formed out of the material which is present in the interior of the earth. Okay, now how they appear? Mostly these rocks, they are hard. Okay, they are hard and they are homogeneous. Homogeneous means which are of same kind. Okay, homo means same. Okay, so they are what? They appear hard and they are what? Homogeneous. Okay, these are heavy as well. Okay, they are what? They are hard and they are heavy. Okay, so we are right now what we are learning? We are learning the characteristics. Okay, and also children, here, what are fossils? We have been learning about the fossil fuels and everything since our fifth standard. Okay. Now fossils are what? They are formed out of the remains of remains of plants and animals. Yes, when the plants and animals die, we obtained what? When they decompose and all, after the decomposition process takes place, okay, the fossils are formed. Okay, so here what happens in such rocks? Fossils are not seen. So remains of plants and animals are not seen in such rocks. Okay. Now, the Maharashtra Plateau and Sahyadris are formed out of igneous rocks. Okay. So see children, our Maharashtra Plateau and the Sahyadris, they are formed out of igneous rocks. So they are very heavy and they are hard and they are homogeneous, means they are of same kind. Now, basalt is a major example of igneous rock. Okay, so example of igneous rock is what? Basalt rock. Okay, now, so we learned about the characteristics of igneous rock. Now, see children, here this is the reservoir on a fort. Okay, so see, here what is this children? We will study. You can see water in that fort. Okay. So here, see children, previously we know about that forts are formed out of rock. That the forts, hill forts in Maharashtra, they have lakes or elephant yards. Now they are what? These are the old quarry sites. Now quarry sites means what children? It is a place. Okay, quarry sites are what? They are the place where a large deep pit which is present, okay, and from which stone or other materials have been extracted. Okay, so see, what are the quarry sites? They are what? They are a place where a deep pit is present and from which, okay, which is actually like a large deep pit, okay, from which stone or other materials are or have been extracted. Okay, so such materials or stones have been extracted. So extraction process have been taken place over there. Okay, so now what happens? The rocks are extracted from such sites and used for the construction of the fort and other buildings. So see children, in the pits and dugouts left behind after the rock extraction, water was allowed to accumulate. Okay, you can see over here in this picture how the water is allowed to accumulate in that region, in that place, and in these lakes. Okay, and these lakes and tanks were created out of it. Okay, so see what happens after the rock extraction is done from such sites. Okay, those rocks are used for the construction of the fort and other buildings, and in the pits and the dugouts which are left behind from the rock extraction, the water is allowed to accumulate. Okay, and what happens when the water is allowed to accumulate in this region, lakes and tanks are created. Okay, so now you can see over here from in this picture. Okay, now next are what? Sedimentary rocks. Now what are sedimentary rocks, children? We will study sedimentary rocks are what? See, now this is the second type of the rock. In this picture, you can see different types of sedimentary rocks, children. Now, how are they formed? We are going to learn about the formation of sedimentary rocks, okay? Now, see, children, we know very well in our previous chapters, we have studied that temperature is not same everywhere. Is it same everywhere? No, it is not same everywhere. So, due to continuous variations in the temperature, as we observe, variation in the temperature, rock develop cracks. So these rocks, okay, what happens? These rocks, they develop cracks. Okay, so now what happens here? The water percolating through rocks dissolves the soluble minerals. Okay, what happens? Water percolating. Percolating means draining or filter. Okay, clear? Percolating means what? Draining or filtering. So what happens, children, here? The water, when it is drained through rocks, dissolves the soluble minerals. Okay, it dissolves the soluble minerals in it. So this leads to what? Weathering of rocks. Now children, what do you mean by weathering? Weathering of rock means the breaking down of rocks. The rocks are broken into pieces. They are broken into pieces. Okay, so weathering of rock means when the rocks are, it is what? It is the breaking down of rocks, soils and minerals. Okay, so now here what happens when the water percolates through the rocks, dissolves the soluble minerals. So because of this, weathering of rocks takes place. So they get disintegrated or decomposed. What happens? They get disintegrated or they get decomposed. Okay, well, here the decomposition process takes place, and because of this, what happened? The rocks, they get reduced into pieces. So we see different small pieces of the rocks. Okay, now children, here, now these rock particles, which are these small rock particles, what happens? They get transported. They get transported by rivers, glaciers, wind. Now we know very well rivers flow from hills and all. So what happens? They carry these rocks, okay, with them. So they carry these rock particles with them, okay, these glaciers and wind also, okay, wind flows. So it carries the rock particles with it, and they actually transfer, okay? They transport these rock particles towards the low-lying areas, and these rock particles are deposited in that region, okay? So, for example, if a river is flowing, okay, from a particular region. Okay, so it carries the rock particles with it and it deposit the particles, rock particles in the low-lying areas. Okay, similarly wind, glaciers, okay, they carry the rock particles with it and they transport it, okay, so towards the low-lying areas. Okay, now what happens, children? As we know, wind is flowing, okay? So one by one, these rock particles are transported to the low-lying areas. So one after the other, layers of sediments are get deposited in this way. Now, children, I have told you, sediments are what? Okay, in our previous chapter, we have studied about sediments. Sediments are what? They are the substances that settles at the bottom. Okay, so here what is happening? Here, layers of sediments are getting deposited in this way. One by one, we are observing the layers of rocks. Okay, so now children, what happens? The upper layer, obviously, it is going to exert heavy pressure on the lower layer. Now, let's see. Now, for example, here, this is the lower layer. One by one, the rock particles are getting deposited. Now, what will happen? This upper layer is going to exert pressure, heavy pressure on the lower layer. Okay, is it clear? So because of this, what happens? This leads to the compaction of material. Compaction means as the force to exert force on something. So what will happen? These upper layers, as they are exerting pressure on the material, okay, and it leads to the development of sedimentary rocks. So this is how what happens. See children, in this way, when the upper layer exerts heavy pressure on the lower layer, okay, because of that, what happens here? This leads to what? Compaction of material, and because of this, sedimentary rocks are formed. So see here, one by one layer is deposited, rock layers are formed one by one, layers of sediments, they get deposited in this way. And when the upper layer exerts heavy pressure on the lower layers, because of this, compaction of material takes place and hence sedimentary rocks are formed. Sediments are what, children? Again, I'll tell you, they are what? They are the material, they are the substance which settles at the bottom. Okay, clear? Understood, everyone? Now, moving ahead. See, one can easily see layers in the sediment rocks. So we can observe what is the speciality of sedimentary rocks, that we can see layers in it. Now see children, here we know very well, when the river flows, when the winds are flowing and all, when the wind blows and all that, it carries the dead remains of plants and animals with it. Okay, now what happens? See, with the flowing water, we have learned about the rivers and all. What happens? It carries the plants and animals with it. So what happens, children? Because of this, what happens? While these layers are getting deposited, these sedimentary rocks layers are getting deposited, the remains of dead animals or plants also get buried in these layers. Okay, so what happens? These plants and animals, they are getting buried in these layers. Okay, so now when here what is happening, we can observe remains of dead animals and plants in these layers. Yes or no? So obviously what we are going to obtain? We are going to find fossils in the sedimentary rocks. Now why do we obtain fossils in the sedimentary rocks? Because when this process is happening, the remains of dead plants and animals, they also get buried in these layers. Okay, so hence, we may find fossils in the sedimentary rocks. Okay, Now, sedimentary rocks are what? They are generally brittle and lightweight. Brittle means what? Which can be easily broken into pieces. Okay. And they are lightweighted. Okay. Now, most of them are porous. Porous means what? Which is permeable or where liquid or air can pass. So, see, such sediment in the sedimentary rocks, liquid or air may pass through it. Okay. That is why they are what? They are porous. Sandstone, limestone, shell, corals, they are what? They are the sedimentary rocks. These are the examples of sedimentary rocks. One may find coal seams in sedimentary rocks. So see children, we obtained coals also in the sedimentary rocks. Okay. Last one is metamorphic rocks. Now, what are these metamorphic rocks, children? This is very interesting. Okay. Metamorphic. Okay. Now, children, first of all, I'll tell you the meaning of metamorphosis. Metamorphosis is what? It is the process of transformation from an immature form to an adult form. See, we have learned about metamorphosis in fourth standard. Yes. Okay. So, here metamorphosis is what? Again, I'll tell you, it is the process of transformation from an immature form to an adult form. Now, how this is related to the rocks, children? Now, see, we studied about the volcanic activities. Yes, we studied about the volcanic activities which are happening on the surface and in the water also. So, now here we are going to learn about on the land. Okay. So, whatever volcanic activities and other movements or other earth movements which are happening, okay, they which are taken place on the earth. Okay. Because of that, what happens when these processes, when these activities are happening, the igneous rocks or the sedimentary rocks, okay, in that particular region, they are what? They are subjected to tremendous pressure and heat. Now, what happens? See, children. Now, see, here, if there is any volcanic activity or any other earth movements, okay, which are happening in a particular region, okay, and in that region, the igneous or sedimentary rocks are present. So, what happens, children? These rocks, the igneous or the sedimentary rock, they experience tremendous pressure and heat. They undergo tremendous pressure and heat. So because of this, what happens? Because of this, what happens? This leads to the changes in the nature as well as the chemical composition of the original rocks. Means what? So for example, in a region where there is igneous rock present, and if at all there is a sudden earth movement which is happening or any volcanic activity, any natural process which is happening in that particular region where the igneous rock is present, what will happen? The igneous rock will experience tremendous pressure and heat in that particular region. Okay. So now what happens because of that, children? Because of this tremendous heat and pressure, the nature of the igneous rock, okay, right now we are discussing igneous rock, this is applied to the sedimentary rock also, okay, I am giving you example of igneous rock. So what happens, this igneous rock, it experiences what? Its chemical composition and its original nature changes. Okay, the original composition and the original nature and the chemical composition of that rock changes. Means we have seen the characteristics of igneous rocks. So what happens? We observe changes in those characteristics. Okay, why? Because it is experiencing pressure and heat. Why it is experiencing pressure and heat? Because of the activities, earth's movement, volcanic activities, which is experienced by that rock. Clear? So what happens here? This leads to the change in nature as well as the chemical composition of the original rocks. So changes are being observed. Now what happens? The crystals in the original rocks, the crystals which are present in the original rocks, they get recrystallized, means they are again recrystallized, they are again formed. Okay, so this means that the rock gets metamorphosed. Okay, what it happens, the rock is here, what is it, is undergoing the process of metamorphosis, means like I told you, from the original form it is getting transformed from the original form to another form. Okay, so here the crystals which are present in that original rock, it get recrystallized, and because of this what happens, this means what, the rocks get metamorphosed. Okay, the rocks formed through such process are called as metamorphic rocks. Okay, hence the rocks which undergo such changes, and when the rock is formed because of such process, it is called as what? Metamorphic rocks. These rocks do not contain fossils. Okay, children, these rocks, they do not contain fossils in it. Why? Because here they are formed what? They are what? They are recrystallized, they are transformed into new one. So here they are not going to contain fossils in it, means remains of plants and animals will not be seen over here. These rocks are heavy and hard, okay, because of the process, chemical process and all these which are happening over here. So such rocks are what? Heavy and hard. Now see, children, here you can see this is the chart. Okay, here they have telling us that they are giving the types of rocks, how it was original, what is the name of the original rock. Okay, the photographs or the specimens I have seen, and after it is metamorphosed. Okay, where after the metamorphosis process, okay, what is that rock called as and how it is seen, means how the transformation have been taken place. So types of rock. So there is igneous rock. Granite is an example of igneous rock. Okay. Here, granite is an example of igneous rock. It looks like this. So after the metamorphosis, when after its process, metamorphosis processes takes place, means after it undergoes changes, it becomes what? It is transformed into gneiss. Okay, it is called as what? It is transformed into gneiss. Okay, you can see here, it changes. It is changed into a new rock. Again, basalt is an example of igneous rock. It is changed into amphibolite. Okay, it is recrystallized. It is changed into amphibolite. Next example, limestone is an example of sedimentary rock. When it undergoes tremendous heat and pressure, it becomes what? Marble. So limestone changes into marble. Coal is an example of sedimentary rock. So we obtain diamond from the coal. Okay, children, when the coal experiences such changes in it, it is transformed into diamond. Okay, now sandstone, example of sedimentary rock, it is now changes into quartzite. Shale is an example of sedimentary rock. When it is metamorphosed, okay, when it undergoes changes, it becomes slate. Okay, so you must have understood from these examples how, due to the volcanic activities or due to the earth's movements and all, how the rock experiences changes, and because of such activities, it leads to the formation of new rock. Okay, a metamorphic rock is formed out of the original rock. Okay, now here, this is the map of Maharashtra. Okay, children, this is the map of Maharashtra. You must have learned map of Maharashtra in fourth standard, when you were learning about the history of Shivaji Maharaj. Okay, you have learned about it. So Maharashtra state, Here it is giving information about the distribution of major rocks which are seen in the Maharashtra region, in our Maharashtra state. Okay, now see children, this figure actually, this shows the distribution of major rocks in Maharashtra. Okay, so here we can observe that there are the districts, okay, which are showing different rocks. Okay, now see here. The light gray color is basalt rock, gray dark gray color is granite rock, red one is laterite, and yellow one is sedimentary. So here you can see granite rock is seen at Gadchiroli, some parts of Chandrapur, Gondia, Bhandara, and some part of Nagpur. There you can see the granite rock. Okay, some parts of Nanded, Yavatmal, okay, and in some parts of Sindhudurg, okay, and you can see major part of Maharashtra is covered by the basalt rock. Okay, children, basalt rock is seen in major part of Maharashtra. Sedimentary rock is seen in some parts of Nandurbar, Jalgaon, Dhule, Akola, Buldhana, Amravati. In such parts, it is seen. Okay. Now, laterite rock is seen in the Sindhudurg and in Ratnagiri. In that particular region, it is seen. Okay, so see children, you must have understood from this map. So here, the basalt rock formed out of volcanic eruption, it has spread over a vast region of our state. Granite rock is found in the eastern parts and in South Konkan. Laterite is found in South Konkan region, okay, which we have seen right now. So now see children, because of thick and extensive layers of basalt, Maharashtra does not have large reserves of mineral wealth, okay. Why do not we have large reserves of mineral wealth in our state? Because of thick and extensive layers of basalt rock. And basalt rock is seen in major part of, it is covering major parts of Maharashtra region. Therefore, children, what happens? Mining activity is concentrated in the South Konkan and in Eastern Maharashtra. Okay, so in Eastern Maharashtra, you can see in the Eastern part, see here, this is the eastern part. Here, the mining activity, and in the South Konkan region, there the mining activity is taken place. Okay, so this was clear, children. So here what happens? Mining activity is concentrated in the South Konkan and in eastern parts of Maharashtra. Now here, children, we'll study about the coal, how coal gets metamorphosed, okay? When the coal, it gets metamorphosed when it undergoes heavy pressure and intense heat, okay? When it experiences heavy pressure and intense heat, it gets metamorphosed. And after this rock gets metamorphosed, it gets converted into diamond. So after coal gets metamorphosed into diamond, its price increases, okay, its value increases. Okay, so now children, we burn coal. Okay, see what happens here. You must have seen that we burn coal while we use diamond as ornaments. Okay, what is the use of diamond, children? It is used as an ornaments and all, but here coal is used for many purposes, for burning and all. Okay, so here from this you can understand that the original rock is used for this purpose, while when it is metamorphs, it is used as an ornament. Okay, so see how the changes are done, okay, and how do we obtain a different rock from the original one. So this was our lesson number 7, that is rock and rock types.